Hi guys, my name is Anu Jindal. Welcome to Morning Tales for 23rd July 2019. Well, if you have not subscribed to the channel, do it now because that will help you not to miss any of these wonderful morning tales that I bring out to you for the upcoming RBI and SEBI examinations. You can also take these quizzes directly now through the website itself. So just go to the website, click on current affairs section or the quizzes section as it is, as you can see it here. And as soon as you click on that, you will be taken or redirected to these morning tales. Okay, so without wasting any time, let's start with the session real quick. The first question is, what is the name of new UGC scheme launched by Ministry of HRD? Because University Grants Commission, as you would all be aware, comes under Ministry of HRD to provide mentorship to institutes and colleges in improving their quality standards and get accredited by NASE. Now, we all are aware about it that the quality of institutes and colleges in India is quite subpar, and therefore in order to improve that, the UGC says that all the colleges or universities or institutions which are doing well above a certain level can be mentors to institutes and colleges which are not doing so well. And in order to do that, they've started a new scheme which is called as Paramarsh. So remember the name of the scheme. I am expecting a question from this scheme in the examination, a very good question and a very important topic indeed. Now, a little bit about NASE. If you want to know about it, you should have some basic idea about what NASE is. Well, NASE is an autonomous institution which was created under University Grants Commission, although it's an autonomous institution, but it is funded by UGC, University Grants Commission, and it was established in 1994 based on recommendations of a national policy on education which came in 1986. So it was established in the year 1994 based on a national policy on education which came out in 1986. This reminds me that the new national education policy is also out, and I've discussed that already in a video in the past. So go through the national education policy very thoroughly, because questions are expected from that as well. Now, the purpose of National Assessment and Accreditation Council, NAACE, is to measure the performance of institutes based on a total of 7 parameters, and it says how an institution or a college or a university is doing. So all these are very obvious parameters, for example, the teaching learning, the evaluation levels, the infrastructure levels, the level of research in these institutes or colleges, what kind of innovation are they coming out with, what is the curriculum that they are following, what is the governance structure that these institutes are following, what is the how is the management performing, what is the student support, and all these aspects are considered in order to measure the performance, overall performance of various institutions. So now UGC says that let's create a scheme wherein all the good performing institutions can become mentors for bad performing institutions and can help them in improving themselves by improving their management, improving their curriculum, so on and so forth. I hope you have understood it. Okay, let's come to the second question. Which state has signed an MOU with British Council to improve the spoken English of students studying in polytechnic colleges? I think it's a very good initiative. It technically means outsourcing, wherein instead of trying to do everything on your own, the government says, okay, let us outsource these activities to universities or institutions or various organizations which are doing it professionally. British Council is known as an institution or an organization which can help people learn English better. So instead of doing it on your own and trying to manage everything, you will outsource it and let the professionals do their job. And keeping that in mind, West Bengal government has identified and entered into an MOU with the British Council. So the answer to this question is West Bengal. Let's come to the third question. I think it's one of the most important questions for today, and I'll be discussing a lot of additional information as well. The question is, where will the 8th edition of Indo-China joint military exercise hand in hand be conducted? The answer is Meghalaya. It is going to be conducted in Meghalaya, the 8th Indo-China joint military exercise, which is called as Hand in Hand. So this is something that you need to remember as well. So two questions are out here. Indo-China joint military exercise is called what? It's called Hand in Hand, number one. And where is it going to be held in the year 2019? It's going to be held in Meghalaya. A number of other joint military exercises which I'm going to discuss now. And if you know any other joint military exercise which I'm not going to be able to discuss, please provide it in the comment section below. Let's start with Russia. India and Russia. What is it called? It's called as Indra. Okay. Coming to Singapore. Singapore, we have two exercises with Singapore. We have one called Agni Warrior. Agni Warrior with Singapore. And then we have another one called Bold Kurukshetra. Let's just remember Bold. Okay. With let's come to Sri Lanka now, which is closer to us. So Sri Lanka, we have Slynex and Mitra Shakti. Slynex with Sri Lanka, Sri Lanka and India. And then we have Mitra Shakti with Sri Lanka. Okay, so these are the two major ones with Sri Lanka. With Mongolia, very important and very popular. We have one with Mongolia as well. It's called as Nomadic Elephant. You can remember it by just visualizing Mongolia, which is famously popularly called as a nomadic country. And then you have some exercises with France coming to developing nations. So we have Shakti and Surya Kiran. Shakti and Surya Kiran with France. With France we have only Shakti. With Nepal we have Surya Kiran, sorry. And with Japan, very important. Japan, we have JIMEX, that is Japan India military exercise. Easy name out there. We have one with Seychelles also, which is deep in the Indian Ocean. It is called as Lamithye, very important one. India and Australia, very easy. Osindex, okay. India and Thailand, important one. Maitri, India and Thailand, Maitri. India and UAE, another one important. Desert Eagle is the name. And then we have a lot of other exercises as well. We have one called Malabar, which is a trilateral naval exercise between India, Japan and US. Okay, this is important. This can be asked in the examination. India, Japan and US. Trilateral exercise called as Malabar. Okay, so these are some of the joint exercises, whether bilateral or trilateral, that I've mentioned here. Of course, there are a lot more that needs to be discussed, and you can mention them in the comment section below. I've already discussed all the popular ones and the important ones in the static GK section as well, where I talk about all the joint exercises. In which state is India's first garbage cafe located? I think this is a very good initiative. Might be asked in the examination, might not be asked. The answer is Chhattisgarh. They have come out with a new initiative, the municipal council in Chhattisgarh, and what they're doing is they're creating a cafe wherein the poor people can come with garbage. So for 1 kilo of garbage, they will get an entire lunch. For 500 grams of garbage, they will get morning breakfast. So the purpose is that all the streets are cleaned and the municipal council is able to find it easier to collect all the garbage through a centralized location, through a cafe. And people are also able to eat by collecting garbage, and therefore Swachh Bharat mission can be implemented better or can be realized better. The next question is, where will India's first space tech park be opened? So the purpose of this space tech park, is to increase or improve the research and development in the space technology. Keeping that in mind, a space tech park is being developed in Kerala. In Kerala, it has been developed now. Okay, the entire investment will be made by Vikram Sarabhai Space Center and through ISRO. Okay, that is not very important. Only the name of the state is important here. Which state has signed an agreement with World Economic Forum's Center for Fourth Industrial Revolution Network to launch Medicine from the Sky? Let me explain to you what the purpose of this Medicine from the Sky project is. Medicine from the Sky is a drone project, the purpose of which is to fulfill the emergency needs, not everyday needs, but emergency needs of medical industry. For example, you need an organ on an immediate basis, or you need some kind of transplant in an immediate basis, you need some kind of vaccine or some kind of medical supplies on an immediate basis. This drone project is going to deliver that. Now, this project is being run by World Economic Forum Center for Fourth Industrial Revolution, and Telangana government has come in contact or signed an agreement with World Economic Forum in order to launch and implement and materialize this project. Let's come to the last question for today. The question says, who has been appointed as the chairperson of Inland Waterways Authority of India? A very factual question, but I am expecting this question to certainly be asked in the examination. The answer to this question is D. Amita Prasad. D. Amita Prasad is the answer to this question. A little bit about national waterways. There are a lot of national waterways, but six have been identified till now or are available on the website of Inland and National Waterways of India. The first one is on the river Ganga in northern part of the country. The second one is on Brahmaputra, again on the northern and northeastern part of the country. The third one is towards the west coast of India in the state of Kerala. Okay. The fourth one, National Waterway 4, is on the eastern coast, and it's on river Godavari and Krishna. Godavari and Krishna is National Waterway 4, National Waterway 4. And the fifth one is in the center of India on two rivers again, Brahmani and Mahanadi, majorly Mahanadi River. And the sixth one is proposed and it is on River Barak. Okay. So these are the six major waterways that we have. Now Barak is in Tripura on the eastern coast of India towards Bangladesh in Tripura. If you know the map, you would be able to understand what I'm saying. Okay, so these are the six major inland waterway, national waterways that we have. Now, inland waterways can be created artificially also. National waterways are mainly on the rivers that a country has, and inland waterways can be made using canals, using barrages, using all kinds of man-made developments. Okay, so the new chairperson of Inland Waterways Authority of India, Amita Prasad. Okay, so that is it for today's current affairs morning tales. I hope you liked it. If you did, do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Press the bell icon for most such videos, because I'm releasing these videos on a regular basis, on a daily basis at 8 a.m. in the morning. The purpose is simple. The purpose is to enable you to get up in the morning and cover some questions so that you feel good about yourself and you have something good to talk about. You have some additional knowledge as soon as you get up. It helps you, create that hunger for more knowledge in the day to come. All the very best. Take care. Wait for tomorrow's morning tales.